So there's been a trend about the past 5, maybe 7 years within the composition world, music composition world, to reimagine textures. We always assume and associate with holiday music, except for O Come, O Come, Emmanuel and Carol of the Bells, Christmas music is always happy. It's always major. And we've done that to ourselves. We've programmed society to associate happy chords. Fade, huh? Play me a C and an E, please. Together. There we go. That's happy in Western culture. Play me a C and an E flat. And for some odd and unknown reason, that is evil. We can blame our 17th century church fathers for that. They actually cleansed all religious music. It was actually called the Diabolos in the Musica, the devil in the music. So about, 17th century, so talking about the 1800s, they said, oh, this chord, I guess it was 16th century, 1700s. These chords are bad, and these chords are good. So all the hymn writers that wrote for the church, right, the aristocracy, those that had money, could pay the artist, said that if you write using this mode, this texture, you can't do it on the name God, G-O-T-T, with the umlaut over the O, right? Can't write these chords on the name of God. And for about 100 years, all hymns were sanitized. We have been conditioned to assume that minor is bad and major is happy. It's rubbish. It's just notes. Has no spiritual connotation. It's amoral. It's aspiritual. Has no moral or spiritual context. So get it out of your mind. So we're going to flip that on its head, right? And we're going to take you down a dark path. Haunted sleigh ride. I don't know why it's called haunted, but then again, we've been conditioned. So, haunted sleigh ride. Culture and the times. But do you remember on Christmas Eve, that was when you got your first Christmas gift. Mm-hmm. All right? Yeah. And so the kids don't know what I'm going to do. But our first Christmas gift was always in the form of that crazy red sash mesh stocking. Remember those? Mm-hmm. Specifically, if you're from down south, we always got fruit of some sort, citrus, an apple.
Yeah.
Right? Everybody's like, oh,
yeah.
Brazil nuts, pecans, walnuts, peppermint.
Mm-hmm. Right?
That took me back. So, on your way out this evening, I prepared those for you, minus the nuts. Because, well, peanut allergies are a thing. I don't know who has them. But this is what I do know. Nobody's allergic to a navel orange. Nobody's allergic to a ruby red grapefruit. And nobody would be allergic to peppermint. That's the devil. Right? So it's not Christmas down south if you don't have that quintessential first Christmas gift of the red stocking with the fruit, the citrus, and the peppermint. Everybody's like, oh, yeah. Right. Some things should never go away. I think that's one of the traditions. So on your way out this evening, they're all set up for you directly as you walk out. Just grab one as a little gift to you. But it also, the music of Christmas Eve is music that sets the tone for the remainder of the Christmas season. Christmas carols. The songs that we don't seem to have antiquated language that nobody takes the time to really look up the words meaning. Those are the things that used to be normative in our religious expressions growing up, and I hope they make their way back, if I'm honest. And so, my gift to you for the music of Christmas Eve is the first gift on Christmas Eve.
Thank you.
You've seen the title of the program, Santa the Barbarian. Who's he? So reimagining of the story. Have you seen the movie, or maybe not, because you know me, Church Christians? Fat Man. You seen that? Mel Gibson as the murderous Santa?
Yeah.
Yes? Okay, yeah. A couple of you are my speed people. I appreciate you. Thank you. God bless you. Forgive me. But nonetheless, it's this reimagining again. What if Santa was some dude you did not want coming into your home in the middle of the night? That's still creepy, by the way, even without it being a barbarian. But nonetheless, imagine if he had nefarious intentions. Well, we're going to see what that might look like. There might be a special guest to visit us. Again, and make those of you that are uncomfortable happy again. This is definitely one of my favorite songs that I've introduced over the past several years. It's entitled Snow Day Celebration. And the subtitle of it is For Every Kid That Knows the Feeling. You ever have this thing that you can remember that you can't put a name to? It doesn't have an adequate name. It's an emotion that you can't name. And I think this is what this is trying to encapsulate. And so this song is writing or has painted the feelings of what it feels like to be out on a school snow day for every kid that knows the feeling. So this is our next to last song. Hope you enjoy it. Extremely hard work this semester, coming back in, embracing a new normal, and of course, setting this off right. So, I'm going to leave you with Christmas Festival.